Hi, my name is Alfred, and I'm one of the neurosurgeons at Boston Children's Hospital. Today, I hope to be able to answer some questions you may have about what we think about when we see patients with brain aneurysms. For example, what are the problems that we encounter, as well as some of the ways that we treat them, whether it's endovascular or open surgery. So today we're in one of the angiography suites. This is one of the core parts of a lot of aneurysm treatment and management for patients. We use this room to diagnose brain aneurysms, as well as to sometimes treat them using minimally invasive strategies when we can. Your first question is likely, what is a brain aneurysm? Ultimately, it is just a weak point of one of the blood vessels of the brain, and it can cause problems in a number of different ways. First of all, a brain aneurysm could have a little tear in it, and that could lead to bleeding inside the head, and that bleeding could directly injure the brain. Ultimately, that's the most serious event, and that's the most worrisome that we see or hear about. However, brain aneurysms can also cause problems by becoming large enough that they push on the structures right around them, whether that's nerves that control the structures of the head and the face, or the brain tissue itself, which controls really all aspects of the body's function. Finally, another way that brain aneurysms can cause problems is by altering the blood flow, creating blood clots that move from inside the aneurysm into the normal blood vessels and actually cause inadequate blood flow in another region of the brain. You may ask, what are some of the ways that we find aneurysms? These are three of the symptoms that we can see people having that may end up leading to a diagnosis of an aneurysm. But we also often see aneurysms when people don't have any of these symptoms and they get a picture for another reason, whether that's for things like a car accident or some trauma, or because there's some family history of an aneurysm.